You know, his translation is very good, but some people say that no, English was not his first language.
Mm.
So he uses very difficult words in his translation,
mm-hmm.
which needs a dictionary to understand it. Yeah, you know, his translation is very good, but some people say that no, English was not his first language.
Mm.
So he uses very difficult words in his translation,
mm-hmm.
which needs a dictionary to understand it. This is one thing. Secondly, I mean, he seems to be very much influenced by Mu'tazila's thought, Mu'tazila's idea,
mm-hmm.
you know, always putting the reason before the revelation, as it was with them. Their idea was that reason comes before revelation.
Mm-hmm.
And they gave a practical example that for every person, it is important, essential, that they should recognize God,
mm-hmm.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by their reason. Mm-hmm. There is no need for a prophet to come, for a revelation to come to tell them. They should find it by themselves.
Mm-hmm.
Now, this is how their idea of reason is.
Yeah.
So we find that Muhammad Asad is very much influenced by them. And then in his tafsir, in his translation, you may find a footnote coming many very often from Zamakhshari's tafsir,
mm-hmm.
which is a fantastic tafsir. But this is one thing which was noted with him. I don't know how much information from his background is taken is that translation.
Mm-hmm.
Because these people, you know, they become very hostile to their previous religions.
Mm.
Right?
Not so much so the information he brings, but the approach. Because with Jews, they have a tradition of arguments or being able to engage in dialogue or with interpretation very deeply.
Yes, of course, then it is there. Because if you follow the path of Mu'tazila,
mm-hmm.
you will be always trying to convince your opponent by your reasoning, by your intelligence. They were not people who can accept something you said just like that. No.
Mm-hmm.
Bring evidence.
Mm-hmm.
Show us how it is.
Mm-hmm.
And they referred to logical evidence, things based on reasoning. And to them, reason was paramount in this, that a text from anywhere can be interpreted.
Mm-hmm.
Its meaning is not very fixed, very final. But what is dictated by reason, nobody can challenge.
Mm.
What is proved by reason, nobody can challenge. This is what their idea was.
Mm-hmm.
So definitely, Muhammad Asad now hears two things, Mu'tazila and then his former religion. Both of them may have influenced him in this approach to the Quran.
Okay.